What's up, Hat Nation? This is Tony. Hope everybody's doing well. Listen, guys, I want to apologize for being gone so long. People have been writing me, saying, hey, man, where you at? I need a video, you know, XYZ, man. And we've just been very busy with a lot of things, one of which is what you're looking at right now. This is some of the components of my trading system that I am working on currently. It's two components here. I think three components here. And so we've been in the lab really beta testing and working with developers and all those kinds of things to make sure that this product is pristine and it is very accurate, guys. So I want you to do me a favor. I want you to like, I want you to share, I want you to subscribe and hit the notification bell right now, guys. Hit it right now so that you can be up to speed with what we're going to be doing here at My Wealth Hack, okay? But guys, I want to start a new series today of conversations that I'm going to call Have You Considered. Okay, now in this series we're going to challenge some of the core thoughts and concepts that a lot of traders have for no other reason than you've always done it or you saw somebody else do it. And I want to challenge you to consider maybe another stream of thought, maybe a better way to be profitable in the market. Okay, so our first topic today is, have you considered trading higher than 1-to-1? Now, by that I mean by your risk to reward ratio. Okay, there are a lot of people who are very profitable trading 1-to-1. Okay, but I want to just challenge that and show you with the system that I have here how we could possibly squeeze out a higher risk to reward ratio without increasing our risk. When you go for a higher risk to reward, these are the benefits that you reap. Okay, here is a risk to reward win percentage to break even. We're not even talking about being profitable, okay? This is just so you can get to break even. As you can see, if you do a 1-to-1, you have to be right 50% of the time, which is like, okay, well, you know, that's decent. That's like a coin flip, okay? In order to be break even. But if we simply go to 1-to-2 risk to reward ratio, look at this, guys. Our win rate only has to be 33% in order to be break even, meaning that we can lose 77% of our trades and still be at break even, still have our capital preserved. Okay, now let's increase that to 1-to-3. Look, 25% win rate in order to remain at break even, meaning that you can lose 75% of your trades. Let's go further, guys. Look, 1-to-5 risk to reward ratio, meaning all you have to do is be right 17% of the time. Now, guys, that's pretty bad. If you're losing that much, you might want to consider not trading. But even if you did, look, guys, you can be wrong. You can be wrong, guys, 83% of the time and still have your capital preserved. Okay, guys, so the chart speaks for itself, guys. Of course, we never want to get anything that's less than 1-to-1, right? But look at this 1-to-1 ratio. It's like a coin flip. But the better the risk to reward ratio you get, the less accurate you have to be. Okay, and when you get the wins, you can get exponential profit. Okay, guys, we believe in trading off the rejection of higher time frame structure to have confluence of multiple time frame movement. Okay, so for instance, we see here, we see the daily, we see the 4-hour being rejected. It rejected once, it rejected twice, and then our algorithm gave us confluence of time to enter. Okay, okay, upon entering here, we would get in on this candle. We only had to put a stop loss of about 50 pips. As you can see right here, we've almost made our 1-to-1 right here. Okay, but look at all this beautiful move that is left, guys. So that's our 1-to-1 right there. Okay, let's say we take it up to this peak. That's 250 pips. That's 5-to-1 just right there, guys. And so if you can imagine and fathom that, if we wait for the right entries, if we wait till for not only the right entries but the right moments, and that's what I love about this indicator that I was able to come up with, is that it gives you the optimum entry. Okay, is it wrong to get in here? No. If it had you put it behind a daily and a 4, hey, you would have definitely won this trade. Okay, But looking at that trade, let's look and see if we put it back behind here, which is not wrong, okay? Putting it back there, we're talking about 137 pips, guys, okay? Which means in order to get our 1-to-1, we have to wait. We have to wait for it to go all the way up here. So you would have won the trade, okay? But you would have only won with a 1-to-1 risk to reward. Meaning, if you had only risked $100, you only would have made $100, okay? Versus, if we wait to the optimum entry with just 50 pips, by the time we get to that same 137, that same $100 that you would have risked has now turned to $300 in the same amount of pips that taking the 137 pip stop would have, okay? And so we want to just challenge you guys to try to find tighter entries. And I don't mean trying to act like you're scalping on your trading on the 30 minute, okay, guys? But there are certain confluences that when momentum enters the market and it crosses certain thresholds, okay? Now, I will recommend my indicator, but it's not available yet, okay? But guys, you can see with your eyes that when price crosses a certain threshold with volume, it never comes back, okay, guys? So what I would kind of recommend to you when you see setups, and I don't care what system it is, guys, okay? When you see setups, don't simply jump in whenever you see an arrow, okay? Let the market tell you when it's ready. It's like the oven in your home. You don't turn on the oven and then immediately stick the pizza in. Per the instructions on the box, it says preheat the oven to maybe 350 or 400 degrees, and the oven will let you know when it's ready. And I'm telling you guys, the market will let you know when it's ready, whether you're using price action, whether you're using indicators, or a combination of both of them. The market will tell you when it's ready, okay? And we can look, we can even look here. We see the rejection of higher time frame structure. We don't jump in immediately because that's too herky-jerky right here, right? But we wait to the optimum entry, guys. And when we wait to the optimum entry, we see that everything is in alignment. We have volume to support our entry. We get a short stop loss, okay? Short and safe, okay? We're not being reckless here. We're not being reckless, but we are looking for optimum entry. So let's say another 50 pip stop loss again, okay? 50 pip stop loss, guys, it never came back, okay? That's your 1-to-1, like right here. If you take it all the way down here, guys, look at this. This is almost 500 pips right here. Okay, so you're looking at a 10-to-1, meaning if you risked $100, you would get 1,000 for $100 risk, guys. Okay, so I just want you to consider, I'm not trying to tell you how to trade. Again, I am not your financial advisor, but I would just want to just encourage you, consider going higher than 1-to-1. By simply doing two things: waiting for optimum entry, okay, minimizing to a safe but closer stop loss, okay, and then holding on to a winner when you have a winner, okay. My system lets you know without a shadow of a doubt that you're still in a downtrend or you're still in the uptrend, okay. But we only take entry when we see fresh rejection from higher time frame structure. So guys, I hope that this was thought provoking and it provided some value and gave us some material to start having a conversation about. Are you a short term trader? Are you a 1-to-1 trader? What is your minimum risk to reward, okay? And have you been profitable with that? When you're going for a long risk to reward, let's say a 4-to-1, 5-to-1, do you have the discipline to stay in the trade when you have little pullbacks like these? Or do you get nervous and take your profit, okay? All of these play into the mentality of what it takes to be a profitable trader, okay, guys? I hope that this brought some value to you guys. And be on the lookout for more valuable content as we share in this series, Have You Considered? Guys, have a great day and happy trading. Peace.